Service. This is Dikshit Kumar. So you can see the details of bushed bearing. So we have completed all the items and we have assembled the bushed bearing. Now we will create the assembled drawing. For that, go to Solid Edge, click on Drawing. Now we have to set the sheet size. For that, you have to right click here, Sheet Setup, Background, now set as A4. So I will untick this Show Background, click on OK, click on Fit. Now you have to select Drawing View Wizard. There you have to pull down the bushed bearing assembly. So I will make it as .asm. So this is the bushed bearing assembly. So click on that and click on Open. Click Next. There I will select the named views as Front. Click on Next, then click on Finish. So just paste here. So this will become the front view. Now we have to select the principal view and click on the front view and just drag it like this. So this is the top view. Similarly, using same principal view, click on the front view and move towards the side. So this will become the side view. Also, you can generate the isometric view. So you can see the four different views. So I will just adjust it. So you can adjust based on the space available. Now I have to generate the bill of material. For that, I'll be selecting the isometric view. So you have to go to the part list, click here, then click on part list. Now you have to select the isometric view. Just click over isometric view. Make sure that the part list auto balloon is on. Now it is on. Then click on finish. So you can see the bill of material has been generated. I'll just fit here. So this is the bill of material. Now this ballooning need to be adjusted. For that you have to select this, then you have to click here, select tool item count, you have to click here, so it will off. Just adjust, click here and click this, you have to switch it off. Also this one. Now I'll be adjusting all this space. For that, just right click over the table, select Properties. Now here go to Columns. Now you can see the various columns here. First one is the item number, so I'll be selecting the item number. So I'll just make it as item number in short. Then the width I will keep it as 10 mm. Next, document number. So document number, it is not required, so just I will remove this. Click on remove. Then comes the title. So the title, you can see the width is almost 50 mm, so I will reduce it to 15 mm. Next, the text alignment. So the heading, it is at center, and the data, it is at left. So I will click on center. Next, the material. So the width is 25, so I will reduce it to 15. Then the data alignment, I will make it as center. Next, the quantity. So I will make it a short, that is QTY quantity. The width I will change to 10, so both are at center. Just click on OK. Now as soon as I click OK, you can see the modification happening here. So just I will click OK. So this is the reduced size. So I will place it over here. So this will become the bill of material. Just click on text and click here. So just type as BOM, it is bill of material. Now you can put the border for this drawing. For that you have to select the rectangle, just click here, move like this, then come down. So this will become the border. Then you have to apply the dimension. For that I'll be using smart dimension. So just select the dimension, just click and put the dimension. And also you have to name all the views, that this is front view and this is top view. Similarly you have to name all these views. This is top view, this is left side view, and this is isometric view. Now just to save time, I've already created a drawing separately, so we'll just open it. So .dft. So this is how the end drawing should be. Of course I have not put the border here, so you have to type the heading. So you have to put all the dimension like this using smart dimension. You have to name the views, and of course you have to generate the bill of material. And at last you can enter your register number here. That's it. So this is the drawing of the boost bearing assembly. Thank you for watching.